All right, it's time. Episode 2 of Bulldog Banter. Donnie, Sam, we're fired up for our next guest from the Wingate football team. But Donnie, I got to tell you, first episode, I think it went smooth. How did you think it went?
I loved it.
Yeah?
I loved it. And if it's possible, I'm more excited for the second episode. We got a Wingate legend in the building. Get up for Lawrence Pittman. Come on in, LP. What's up, man?
What's going on?
You guys doing good?
Yeah.
Good, man. Thanks for coming in.
I know you got a packed schedule.
Yeah.
Coaching.
Yep.
Doing a lot.
You fit us in. We appreciate that.
Yeah, happy to be here.
Yeah.
Happy to be here.
How's everything going?
It's going good. You know, just I'm glad to be back, you know, helping out with the football team, you know, coaching the running backs. We got a lot of talent, obviously, you know, at the running back position. So it's just glad to be back and help out with the team.
Yeah, I'm sure those guys are probably striving to be.
Yeah,
like I wanna accomplish what LP accomplished, right?
we got some good ones, you know. Nigeria, he's really good. Dom, we got some talent, you know, at running back. So I'm just happy to help them, you know.
Yeah.
Help them out with some of the stuff I learned and
right.
You know, stuff I wish I would have had, you mm-hmm. know, when I was here. So I'm like,
sure.
You know, I'm just really happy to, you know.
That's awesome.
To bring what I can bring to the table. You know?
Yeah. So.
How much do you miss actually? I know because you're around the team.
Yep.
But how much do you actually miss, like when you're around the team, but you know you're not actually going to suit it up on Saturdays
yeah.
or Thursdays?
Yeah.
Then, you know, first game's Thursday. Do you miss it at all
yeah,
playing? How much
definitely.
Do you miss it?
I mean, I miss, you know, obviously I love the game of football. You know, I love it. You know,
mm-hmm.
So being around it, you know, I'm like, seeing, you know, guys make a run or something, I'm like, oh man, like, if you would have just did this.
You would have done it, right?
Yeah,
right?
Like, or, you know, just doing it like that. And, you know, practice, you know, we were there all so long, you know, it's like, I miss the game, I love it, you know, so it feels good to be back out there. You know?
Yeah, I can't imagine, especially you coming back and coaching
mm-hmm.
on the side, just that itch that you get.
Yeah, definitely.
But so, you're not too far removed though.
No, I'm not.
So.
You know, I play with, you know, some of the guys on the team, you know, so we all have a good relationship, obviously, you know. And it, you know, it's good to, it's different to see it from this side of the from this perspective.
Yeah,
of,
different lens.
The game, you know, it's like, you know, I've learned so much, you know, from playing professional football, you know, over the couple of years I've been there, and you know, I'm just happy to bring what I can bring to the team.
What's it been like being called Coach Pittman?
Is it
weird?
Like, it's kind of weird.
I mean, you're not old either, so it's not like you're, you know.
The guys have to call you that?
I mean, I told them to call me whatever they wanted to call me, you know, LP or Pitt, you know, whatever they want to call me.
You're not too formal.
Well, what about the freshmen?
Some of the younger, like the freshmen, they call me Coach Pitt. Like, that's all they know me as a coach, and it's kind of weird. I'm like, okay. Like,
you're like, stop.
That's funny.
It's kind of weird, but I mean, it's cool, though, you know. It's a good experience. You know, I can definitely see myself, you know, after I'm done, you know, fully playing professional football, coaching, you know, I can definitely see myself doing that down the road. So it's great to get the experience now and, you know, be full in. You know, Coach Wright, he lets me be hands on with the running backs, you know, so I'm running my own drills and, you know, it's kind of cool, like, you know, making the drills up and asking them, like, oh, do you guys like this? Or, you know, do you guys like this drill?
Yeah,
you know, what do you guys want to do? So,
right, exactly.
Yeah, it's really good. It's fun.
And you earned that, I mean, with what you accomplished at Wingate. Mm-hmm. What are some of the biggest takeaways that you had from your time playing football here at Wingate?
I mean, I enjoyed it all, honestly. Like, you know, it was a journey, you know, playing as a true freshman, you know, scoring the first game. That was like my first time scoring my first touchdown was at Limestone my freshman year. And then just seeing my growth, you know, throughout the whole thing was really good. Good experience, you know. I had a lot of moments that I really, you know, cherish, you know, being with the team, obviously mm-hmm. winning the SAC conference championship my senior year was really big, you know, it was really good for me to go out on top, you know, and win a ring, you know.
You're not wearing the ring, are you?
I don't have it.
Where's the ring at? Come on now. You come
and
show up.
He's got the chain, he's got the stuff. No ring.
You come and show up here without the ring?
I have the ring, you know, I got it with my high school state championship. I got them like next to each other. I got them back home. My mom like keeps all my like, accolades
cool.
and stuff like that. So. I just keep it at home and keep it
that's
in a safe,
fair.
Safe
that's
place,
fair.
You know.
We'll give you a pass. We'll give you
yeah.
A pass.
I mean, your name, speaking of accolades, your name comes, you ever look at that Wingate record book on the website?
Yeah, I mean, people tell me about it, you know, here and there, some of my accolades I have, you know. It was great, you know, to be the all-time, you know, score touchdowns and score, I think, all-time leading touchdown leader here at Wingate. So, you know, it's a blessing, definitely, to leave my name and leave my mark, you know,
yeah.
on the team.
I think one thing that stands out about some of those records is your durability. You've got three, your name is listed in three of the top four of being, in terms of rushing attempts, mm-hmm. like actually being given the football regardless of yardage.
Yeah.
Your name is up there constantly. So like, how do you explain that? Like how did you become so durable and reliable?
I really just trained really hard. Like every summer, like off season was like, I feel like that was my season, like the off mm-hmm. season. Like that's literally what I would prepare for. I would, you know, do a lot of conditioning because I never wanted to come off the field. Like I just wanted to be on the field as much as I could, you know, to help the team. So I knew that if I was in really good shape and had really good wind, then I could, you know, stay on the field longer and, mm-hmm. you know, obviously be right. more productive on the field. So
exactly.
Yep.
That's cool.
What is the best memory you had at Wingate playing?
Best memory.
You got one game, one play. What you got for us?
He's got a lot.
it's hard to break it down to just one. A lot of people say they really like my sophomore year at LR. They were like a nationally ranked team at the time. It was like a nationally televised mm-hmm. game too. And they were really good. I think maybe a couple years ago, before that, they won like a national or international championship or something like that.
Yeah, I think they.
So they were a really good team, and I had like a really, like I think I had like 200 yards on like, I don't know how many carries. I don't know, a lot of carries, but I had like a really good run versus LR. You know, it was at LR. I think I carried a couple people on the back. You know, took a lot of people to bring me down, but that was probably like that game really, I felt like, you know, put me over the top as far as like, status and everything with around the conference, you know, like kind of like, oh yeah, he's for real, you know, he can play football. So
coming in, you mentioned like true freshman. Mm-hmm. Was your confidence level there? You said like that Lenoir Ryan game was like what put you over the top. How was your confidence when you came in and you were kind of just given the rock?
I mean, I've always been a confident person. You know, I always believed in myself. You know, from the moment I stepped on the campus, you know, mm-hmm. I Wingate was my first offer. Okay. So
interesting.
I really, you know, Coach Jordan, they recruited me here. You know, they believed in me, and I, you know, so the moment I came here, I was like, you know, I'm just gonna be all out and, you know, try to do everything I can to help the team win. And, you know, I came in as a true freshman and I got a chance to play, got the opportunity to play. So for the moment I've been here, I've always, you know, believed in myself and was confident, you know, mm-hmm. but I worked hard to, you know, get better. And every year I try to get better, mm-hmm. you know.
And being at Mallard Creek too, big, obviously.
Yeah.
Now, and last week they were just on ESPN2.
Yeah, it's great.
What do you think of that?
Pretty cool. Yeah, I was just watching that game. I was like,
that's awesome.
I'm like,
that's
man,
my
I'm,
squad.
Yeah. I'm calling on my boys from, you know, calling on my boys, you know, who I play with at Mallard Creek.
So
and
cool.
We're like, we're all watching the game. We're hyped because, you know, we know some of the young guys on the team that are playing. We're like, man, this dude's a beast. Like, Trent Simpson, like, he's balling. Like, he's a beast. Yeah, he's going to be
big time
player mm-hmm. down the road.
And y'all got a lot of others that have gone through, like with you. I mean, Cam Madison, obviously, Jalen Samuels.
Yeah, Jalen Samuels.
Like,
we're
in the
NFL. All close. Like, me, Cam, Jalen Samuels, mm-hmm. Like, we're all best friends. Like,
I remember when you and I, Sam, were in the locker room, we were talking to Cam, and he had Steelers shirt on.
Yeah,
we're like, Steelers fan? He's
I didn't realize
that. I just know Jalen Samuels.
Yeah.
And I thought that was so cool, like, you know, small world.
Yeah, it's a small world. You know, we're all real close knit. Like I got off the phone with, I think I talked to Cam literally like pulling up here. Like
oh,
I was
really?
Just talking to Cam. Like, I got
a
little interview with Wingate. He's like, yeah, we're talking and stuff. Me and Jay, he's got a game right. I think he's playing right now, you know, so it's kind of cool.
Preseason.
Yeah, preseason game.
Just
we
NFL,
talk all the time.
NFL preseason.
Yeah.
No big deal.
Well, I mean, hey, you got a little taste of some NFL action right after you left Wingate. Can you tell us a little bit
so
about
I got the, coming out, I left school early, you know, to go train and everything. And then I got the opportunity to, I got rookie mini camp with the Philadelphia Eagles. You know, it was a great experience, you know, getting NFL experience, being mm-hmm. around top talent. You know, you kind of get to compare yourself, you know.
Right,
like, oh, well, these guys went to, you know, big name mm-hmm. schools, you know, and I feel like I'm right there with them, you know, as far as like talent, you know. So it was good to match up with, you know, some Division I guys, you know, former Division I guys and, you know, NFL guys. It was mm-hmm. fun.
So off the field, obviously, you know, you've got a lot of experience playing mm-hmm. pro football. What's mm-hmm. that lifestyle like for you? Like, take us through, like, the typical day of a pro football player.
I mean, typical day is like, you know, it's your job. You know, you get up, depending on depending on where I was at, you know, it was different, little different structure. But you know, get up 6:30, whatever, go to treatment.
That's early.
If you, you gotta set an alarm, or your brain just naturally wakes
definitely
up.
Definitely set an alarm.
If you didn't set your alarm, what time would you be waking up?
I don't know. But if I didn't set an alarm, I mean, I feel like I'll naturally want to wake up. Like,
yeah.
I don't know if it'll be 6:30, but it'll definitely.
It's only so
be
long,
like,
you can sleep.
Yeah, it's only so long. You know, you got to get up early. You know what I mean? You're just gonna be laying there. I would say maybe 8, 7:30, 8. If I know I have to get up at
that's pretty bad.
If I know I have to get up at 6:30, I'm sure I won't sleep till 10
right,
o'clock.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
There's no way I'm gonna let myself sleep that long. But
so wake up treatment. We cut
wake
you
up
off.
Treatment. Eat. After you eat. Then it's normally like we have like staff meeting with the team, going over the practices or going over film. That takes about maybe 2 hours. And then from there you practice. Depending on the day, you might lift before practice. Sometimes you lift after. And then after practice, usually we're done by like 1:30, 2 o'clock, and get some extra work in. But I mean, from there it's like your day's done. You just go home, relax,
your job,
kick your feet up, you know.
So was it, this was during Eagles?
This was more so probably in Canada playing the CFL. CFL schedule, and also the AAF was similar structures. With the Eagles, it was a little longer, like, because it was more like camp. Mm-hmm. So we had like you know, practice, and then we have like long meetings and stuff like that. But
did you ever come across Frank Reich at all when he was with the Eagles?
I think he left actually before he had just got the head coaching job with the
I was going to say,
the
yeah,
coach,
I was
yeah.
the time
so
line,
the time was a little different, but I mean, a lot of the guys that knew him, obviously, they would talk. I told him I went to Wingate, and then, you know, I told him my head coach is Frank Reich's brother. So, you know, they were like, oh, that's cool.
I found that. I was like, wow, that's,
yeah, that blew my mind.
That's wild.
So it kind of hit me. I was watching TV and I'm like, looks like Joe Wright.
Yeah.
I'm like, that's
great. I can't, honestly, I'm trying to remember the first time I realized. I remember I was sitting in Coach Reich's office and we were talking about something and it hit me. I was like, that's your brother.
Yeah, I think I saw him on Twitter.
They do like, look just
you
like.
Gotta be. Yeah, they're like literally mirror image.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So how'd you get from, Eagles rookie camp, and then how did the whole CFL thing get rolling with Montreal? Walk us through that process.
So I took some time off, like after, you know, with the Eagles, you know, I just continued to train, you know. I was just hoping for another opportunity somewhere. I just kept training. And then a CFL scout ended up reaching out to me. You know, they saw that I was still available. And they were like, you know, we really definitely want to take a look at you. You know, so they brought me in. And it happened to be the Montreal Alouettes. John Bowman, a former Wingate legend, he basically, you know, once I went there, you know, I had a really good practice. They ended up signing me. And it was cool playing with John Bowman. You know, he's been like, I think he had the all-time sack record.
Well, it's funny you bring that up. Did you realize, you must not have realized, that after this year, the 2018 season, do you know this?
Yeah, the new sack.
Yeah,
leader. Yeah.
Cardell Rawlings.
Oh, really?
Broke John Bowman's single season sack record.
Oh, he broke it.
He did.
I knew he did. I didn't know if he broke it or not, but that's big time. Yeah, Cardell, that's my guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my guy. That's crazy. Because John Bowman, that's big shoes
that's
right
big
there.
Time. Yeah, that's big time. I didn't know he broke it.
Yeah.
Dang,
okay. You haven't been looking at that record book.
That's not a bad thing.
I know it's not. It really. Yeah, honestly, that was a trick. When I asked you that before, that was a trick question.
Yeah.
I was like, people don't need to be looking at that record.
Yeah.
Yeah, really.
But so how helpful was having John there in Montreal when you got there?
It was a huge
like a big
blessing.
Brother kind of.
Yeah, it was definitely like a big brother. Like, cause I mean. I get off the plane, they pick me up, team picks me up, and I'm walking, and I'm seeing like the street signs, and I'm like looking at them, and they're all in French. And I'm like, whoa, like.
Did you take French in college?
No French.
Okay, so yeah. Yeah, it's no French.
And, like, I'm like, how am I gonna live here? Like, you know, everybody's speaking French, you know. And then John's like, yo, just, you're get used to it. He's like real chill. But yeah, he's definitely like, he took me under his wing. You know, he took me out to eat the first night there, and you know, we just talked football, talked about his times at Wingate, and you know, how much has changed from, you know, from then and now. Cause I think it's like, I think he left in like 2004.
It's been a while. Yeah.
So, you know, he was like 37 when I was there, you know.
He's up there now.
22 at the time. So, you know, it's a big age gap, but you know, obviously him playing football for so long, it's right. like.
You're both pros too.
Both so, pros, yeah. It was just, right. you know, it was a good experience to have him there and, you know, show me the ropes a little bit, you know, give me great insight on the league and, you know, things I need to do, what not to do, you know. So it was definitely great, like a big brother experience. I talk to him off and on even now.
One other guy notably played for Montreal, Johnny Football.
Yep.
Johnny Manziel. Yep. Yep. You have any stories with Johnny
Yeah, I mean,
Football
he's a cool dude. I enjoy playing with him. We spent some time together. We go out to eat. You know, mm-hmm. he was a cool dude. We keep in touch, you know, here and there.
That's pretty cool.
You know, he played, actually, he left Montreal and joined the AAF as well.
Right, that's right.
So, you know.
That's right.
We were gonna get to play each other, I think, mm-hmm. at the time. I think we would play maybe
in the league photo.
I think we were gonna play, but it was cool. He was real cool. He's a real cool guy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Biggest difference that you noticed from Eagles rookie camp mm-hmm. to playing in the CFL? I mean, I know there's a lot, but.
I mean, obviously the field is, it's different rules, but the field is like, it's like really wide. I think it's extra 10 yards wider, I believe, or maybe 15. But it's a wider field. It's longer, I think, as well. It's big, you know. It's a big field.
I didn't know that. I had no clue.
Yeah, and it's 12 on the field instead of 11. So it's 12 on the field. So
I need to do some more research on CFL.
Yeah, the line, the defensive line is actually a yard off the ball versus on the ball.
Okay.
So that gives you an extra little push offensively.
Right.
And it's a pass-heavy league. Just because the field is so wide, you can run a lot of different combination routes. And the back of the end zone is the end zone is 20 yards versus 10.
Okay.
So you can get a lot of deep routes in the back of the end zone. So it's kind of cool. Yeah.
How many rules do you know about the CFL?
The ones that LP just said. That's about it.
You hear that. You heard that.
That's about it. That's one thing you have on me, Sam, okay? I'm not the biggest CFL.
No, I mean, I can name off a couple CFL teams, but.
Yeah. Can you name all of them?
No shot. I mean, Saskatchewan Rough Riders.
Yep.
Hamilton Tiger Cats.
Yep.
Y'all got this on film?
I'm counting. I got two. What about the one that?
Hold up. The Edmonton Eskimos.
Yep.
LPs. Yeah, I know. Obviously, I know the Montreal Alouettes.
Okay, cool. Thank you. See, man.
Obviously, I know the Montreal Alouettes. Mm-hmm. Calgary Stampedes.
Yep.
Winnipeg Blue Bombers. All right, people don't need to.
No, keep going.
Is this interesting?
Yeah, it
okay.
is interesting.
All right.
I mean, if you think it's interesting.
How many more?
Toronto. Argonauts.
Toronto, Argonaut.
Okay. Yeah.
Could you have named all this?
No.
All right.
No.
There's more, but I don't know.
Yeah.
I can't remember.
Okay. All right. Obviously, college, NFL.
Mm-hmm.
Your steps, college, NFL, CFL.
Yep.
Now AAF.
Yep.
Playing with the Atlanta Legends. Take us through that.
Yep.
Any cool experiences? Any notable stories for us?
The AAF was fun. You know, it was a lot of. I think it was a lot of NFL guys. You know, previous NFL guys. You know, it was good playing with a lot of legends in different. You know, different from their colleges. You know,
sure.
Denard Robinson.
Yeah, Michigan.
Big Michigan legend, you know. So,
definitely.
And he was in my actual room with the running back. So, you know, it was cool.
That's right, yeah.
We built a really good relationship. You know, he's a really cool guy.
Right.
We keep in touch now to this day. So, you know, it was good seeing a lot of different big names. You know, playing actually in America was fun, you know, because my family could come see me play. And,
of course.
You know, it was on national televised games, you know. So, it was big. It was big for me to play.
You played with Aaron Murray, right?
Yes.
I'm a big Georgie guy. So
yeah.
I had to get that in there.
Boy.
Go Dogs.
Yeah, Aaron Murray.
Oh, no.
Is he a good guy?
He's a good guy. He's a good guy. Aaron Murray was cool.
He's a good guy.
He's cool, yeah.
Nah, I don't know, but, you know. LP
Georgia legend.
Cool. Yeah, he is a Georgia legend.
I was watching a piece of one of your games, and I remember seeing you get a carry.
Yeah.
And they said
the announcer, Andrew Catalan from CBS, he was like,
yep.
Wingate, proud of Wingate.
Yep, it was cool, yeah. I heard everybody was, you know, hit me up, like, Wingate this, Wingate that. You know,
yes, so. We know you're wearing a Wingate polo.
Sorry.
I mean, it was good to represent Wingate
always,
on the national stage, you know,
always.
It was cool.
Yep. So another thing, obviously, on your Instagram, you got a picture with Michael Vick.
Yep.
That's not a, you know, ordinary post. take us through that. Do you still talk to Mike? Are you guys close?
I mean, we're cool, you know. We got to know each other a little bit, you know, Mike Vick. He was just telling me, like, before a game, you know, just, you know, run hard, things like that. Mm-hmm. So it was cool to, you know, get that picture, you know. It was real brief, but, you know.
You know, it's crazy, like, you hear Mike Vick say anything as simple as run hard. It's like, I'm going to take that really
Mike
seriously.
Vick just told me
run hard? Yeah, definitely.
Right.
As opposed to, like, if I was, like, LP, run hard, you'll be like,
I looked
whatever.
Up at Mike
who's
Vick.
This,
like,
who's this guy?
I remember playing with him on Madden in, like, 2007.
That's what,
like,
that's what it was.
Like, see him face to face was, like, really cool, you know.
That's what I think is one of the most underrated things in sports. people like you have stories that like not an ordinary person could have.
Yeah.
You cool. played with a guy in Madden, and then he was your coach.
Yeah, that's cool.
And
yeah,
you interact. I think that's, I just think that's really cool.
Yeah.
Being just like a sports nut and being around guys like that, I think that's awesome.
Yeah, it was cool.
That's awesome.
Cool.
All right, so we know you love football, but you also have a little side passion.
Yep. I love to draw. I've been drawing.
Let's get our producer, Elliot Zirwas. I didn't mean to cut you off, but we got some, I'm just fired up to see this artwork you got here.
Yep. So I got some art here. Michael Jordan. Did this a few years back. It's colored pencil. Yeah, it was pretty cool.
Yeah. You know,
cool to draw. God. You know, I like to do art in my free time. I've been drawing ever since I was little. So it was just something to do, you know, definitely during my free time, just kind of relax, kind of ease my mind. Another picture here.
Thanks, Elliot.
LeBron James.
That's, I like that.
I'm a big time really LeBron good. James
Whoa.
Fan.
Whoa.
Oh my God.
So I did this.
So when did you start doing stuff like this? When did you realize you're like, I'm pretty good at drawing?
Actually, my mom, I didn't notice I was good at art until like, I guess my mom, like in kindergarten was like, they were like, my kindergarten teacher were like talking about like my art.
And
they
were, this like, was back in kindergarten.
They were like comparing the art to different, like this is his and then look at this. Like, you see the big difference, like how detailed it is. And I was like, I was just drawing what I see. Like, right. I didn't really think anything
that's,
of it.
That's cool.
And then I ended up going to a school of the arts back in middle school. And it kind of helped me out a little bit.
It
started a ways back.
Yeah,
this
wasn't
like a couple years ago.
Yeah, I've been drawing, I've always had art, you know. Obviously, I don't have as much time like as I want to really, you know, but when I do find time, free time, I always sketch and, you know. So it's cool, it's good, it's something to have, you know.
Right.
You working on a project right now?
I'm starting one. I'm starting to plan on ideas. I'm mapping it out and everything. So it's kind of like a rough sketch, but maybe in the near future, I'll show you whatever.
Yeah.
Post it or something on Instagram. You
know? This third one right here, take us.
Actually, I did this one here at Wingate right before I left. Okay. So we had like a self-portrait type of thing.
I can't see it.
This was like at Wingate. My bad.
I'm kidding.
You know, this is like a little self-portrait.
Wow, look at that. You did that with...
This is charcoal.
Okay.
Yep. I did this. It was actually, I had a Wingate jersey on. This is from on the field. Like, somebody just snapped a picture. You know, so.
Wow.
So with drawing, do you like, you have the actual picture up next to it, or you just?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of it is like, I'll see the picture and just draw it, you know.
That's crazy.
But then also, like, create stuff on my own, so, yep.
Picture. That's really cool.
Yep, so that's just, you know, something I like to do in my free time.
Yeah.
I guess it's kind of cool, I guess.
Yeah, I think it's awesome.
Yeah. I can't do that.
you draw anything?
Do I draw?
Yeah.
You know what? I should have brought. I have a portrait. I have a self-portrait that was decent back in middle school. I promise. Why are you looking at me like I'm crazy?
No, I just see LPs and then I just.
I have one.
I'll show it. Okay. I'll send you a photo of it. It's mediocre, but it does a job. It did a job.
So I gotta ask you. Are you a big, like, do you eat healthy? Are you a big, like?
Yeah, I try to eat healthy. I have my cheat days, don't get me wrong.
Okay, so this might apply.
A little double cheeseburger, you know.
Yeah, all that. But this is a new one. The trend now is the Popeye's chicken sandwich.
I heard.
Have you had it?
I heard. I have not.
Okay,
I haven't either, but I'm tempted. Like, I talked to one of my boys, he was like, yeah, he had it. He was like, the bun is so good. I'm just like.
So it's the bun. It's not like the chicken.
First thing he said was the bun. He was like, it's buttery and this, that.
It's like King's Hawaiian roll and then the chicken. The sandwich itself is like, it's pretty big.
It's pretty big.
And I went the other day and the line was literally wrapped
around. That's what everybody keeps saying.
I've never seen a Popeye's like that in my life. Really? Popeye's is always dead.
I'm tempted to get one, actually.
I really want to get one.
Like, I really do.
We should all three go if y'all are interested.
We can definitely do that.
If you have a cheat day.
I'll definitely. I'll work it out. I definitely do want to try one of those chicken sandwiches. I'm hearing a lot of good things about them. So.
Yeah, that I didn't even hear about it until you brought it up earlier.
It's all over Twitter.
Yeah, it's all over Twitter. I've been looking on my. It's like I'm seeing all the memes and all the stuff about them. I'm like, all right, let's get a care. Like, what's all the hoopla about
this? Just a sandwich.
Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean?
Just a sandwich.
So you said you try and eat healthy, or you eat healthy? What?
Yeah, I try to eat like a lot of salads. You know, just to keep my weight down. You know. During my off-season training, try to eat healthy, a lot of subs and things of that nature. You know, I also have my cheat days on the weekends, you know, here and there. Just
always
eat whatever
fun.
I want.
Always fun.
I train so hard, you know, it's like, as long as I'm really training hard and, you know, eating clean, and I feel like a couple cheat days ain't gonna hurt, you know?
Hey, no. A double cheeseburger every now and then?
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Don't mind me.
Yeah. That's totally fine.
Definitely.
So another thing that happened last night, pretty fresh, Andrew Luck retired, 29 years old.
Yeah.
What's your take on that? Are you a big Andrew Luck guy?
Did you? A little bit. I think he's a good quarterback. You know, he battled injuries, you know, throughout his career.
Right.
So, I mean, I'm all for it, you know. I don't feel like you should do something that you, you know, really don't want to do, you know. So, I mean, I'm all for it. You know, if he's happy with his family, you know, if he feels like that's the best decision for him, then, you know, I'm all for it. You know, I support it.
I think it's just not even just the Andrew Luck thing. I think, you look at the NFL now in a larger lens and say how many players that are out there may be thinking the same thing. And Andrew Luck starting potentially a trend of – that's tough.
Very
for
possible.
Sure. Mm-hmm. No doubt about it. Very, very tough to see that happen.
Yeah, but I know a lot of fans. I heard they were like booing and stuff.
Yeah,
I
was
like,
that's what gets me. I don't understand the booing, but
I don't understand that. Like, you know, he's giving everything he has for the organization. Obviously, you know, can't help injuries.
Right.
You know,
so we're gonna switch it up.
Yeah, we're you beat me to it, man.
I'm sorry. I was. It is trivia time. Okay. We've got five. Trivia question.
Wait, what about keep trading drop? We gotta do that first.
Okay, you're right. I'm sorry. I jumped the gun.
trivia time. I'm pumped for trivia time though.
Yeah, we'll get to it. Okay. So obviously NFL guy, running back. Keep trade or drop. Ezekiel Elliott, Saquon Barkley, and Todd Gurley.
It's tough. Oof. I was like my top three.
Yes, me too.
Those are your top three?
Those are my top three right now.
Okay.
In order?
Currently. You said Ezekiel Elliott.
Would you say Saquon at one?
And are you probably
going to... I'm going Todd Gurley one.
Another Georgia guy.
Wow.
All the right answers.
It's hard to go. I'm going to go Todd Gurley. I'm going to go TG one. I'll go...
So you're keeping him?
I'm keeping Todd Gurley.
Okay.
That's tough. Wait, you said keep, trade, or drop?
Mm-hmm. Right.
So if I have a team and I got to keep, trade, or drop, okay.
Yeah.
That's tough. It's between, I think I'm going to keep either between Todd Gurley and Saquon. I think I'll go, I'm going to keep Todd Gurley.
Okay.
I'm a Zeke fan too, but I might have to trade Zeke.
Trade Zeke. You might get traded.
I'm with you on the trade, you said not drop.
Keep, trade, or drop?
Yeah.
I can't drop Saquon either, though. Like, it's like hard to do.
That's the name of the game.
Ah,
it's a tough one.
I'm gonna keep Todd Gurley. I might have to drop Zeke. I hate to say it.
No, but, I mean off the field stuff.
And then trade Saquon, but that's tough too. Cause I mean,
yeah, I know.
He's honestly one or two in the league.
Yeah. But do you mirror your game after any of those guys, or you kind of do your own thing?
Definitely look at, you know, I look at Todd Gurley, I look at Ezekiel Elliott with his, you know, power, you know, and then Saquon with his size and speed. Mm. You know, I definitely model, I watch all of them.
Oh, yeah.
I watch a lot of great players, you know, just to kind of, you know, compare and see what they do well, you know, just to see, you know, try to bring that to my game.
Right.
So now.
Getting to it.
Let's get to trivia time.
Okay.
You ready for this? These are five hard-hitting questions. For LP, our director's laughing.
Are they all,
he's like, crying over there. He's tearing up.
I'm
making him laugh so much.
Are they really that hard? Like,
no, they're not that bad, man. They're pretty easy. All right, I'll start with the first one. All right, which Wingate player shares the record with you for most rushing touchdowns in a game?
That's your people.
One for one. See, you have nothing to worry about.
Yeah, it's big time with him. Especially as a freshman, I was big.
Yeah.
You know, so I was.
What year when you had five? What year were you?
That was my junior year.
Okay.
That was my junior year.
Wow.
Yeah, I definitely shouted him out on Twitter when I seen that.
Right.
Like, whoa! I think I was in Canada at the time.
Yeah.
I seen that. I was like, wow. Yeah, he's doing good.
Big time. Yep. All right, number two. Who was the first running back off the board in the 2017 NFL drafts?
First running back.
2017. This year.
Think hard.
Whew. 2017.
Same amount.
Leonard Fournette?
Wow.
Two for two.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, this has never been done in the history of Bulldog Banter.
Yeah.
All right. I honestly thought that was going to be a little bit tricky.
Yeah, I did too. That's
a good. You said running back. I was like, I'm most likely.
Right. Yeah. All right, Sam. Number three.
All right.
Last sports one.
My phone is getting messy.
You want me to go ahead and do
it's
it?
It's like going in and out. Yeah.
So, since you were born.
God, this is like an iPhone 5, too.
What year? Tell the audience what year you were born. Just year.
95.
All right. Since 95, how many running backs have won MVP of the Super Bowl?
This is a good question.
Since 95.
Oh, my gosh.
How many?
How many times does it happen that a running back has won MVP? This one might get you.
This is definitely going to get me. I'm going to just guess. MVP of the Super Bowl. That's tough. I'm trying to think. Has there been any? Is it?
Go ahead. What's your final guess?
Wow. What you got, LP? Hold up. You're two for two right now.
I know.
I'm two for two. You gotta
get this one.
I gotta get this one. I'm trying to go perfect. Two?
So close.
Very close.
Terrell Davis.
Oh.
The Broncos.
Oh.
Crazy, man. Right?
Isn't I was gonna crazy? Say one or two. I knew it wasn't much.
I looked that up because I was curious and I was stunned.
Yeah.
That only one since you were.
Wow.
And that is crazy.
Yeah, that's crazy. That is crazy, especially because we're used so much. You know, it's like.
Yeah.
Right, I was gonna say.
Jerome Bettison and get one? Honestly, I thought like who the last one was.
I honestly thought it was Jerome Bettison. Yeah. Really, that was like who's popping my head, Jerome Bettison.
Sam asked me last night and I had no clue.
Oh man, I thought it was Jerome Bettison. That's what I was thinking.
But you said Emmitt Smith won one in 93.
Emmitt Smith won in 94. He won in 94.
I thought it was Jerome Bettison and Emmitt Smith. That's why I said two, but I didn't remember yet.
That's crazy. Well, I mean, my phone is dead.
Okay.
So we're gonna have to rely on you.
So this is now away from sports.
Mm-hmm.
See if you know your things with like America.
Okay.
What famous national memorial is located in Keystone, South Dakota? Some may think it's a monument, but it's actually a memorial.
Yeah, I thought it was a monument.
I visited this summer on my road trip. South That's the only Dakota? Reason I know. It's
Low
a national
key.
Memorial in South Dakota. What's like the one thing people know in South Dakota? Elliot doesn't know.
I know Julian doesn't
Julian
know.
Julian does
a
not
fact.
Know. Josh may know. Josh doesn't know. Think about it.
I have no idea. Like, I don't even know where to start.
Mount Rushmore. Okay, right. Now they say okay.
Now they say it.
Like, right.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, right. Okay?
Okay.
I apologize.
All right, last one. So, what, two for four?
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's
you still got a chance to go three for five.
Okay.
It's still Let's really it. Solid. All right. You said you're an art guy.
Mm-hmm.
One of the most famous artists, Pablo Picasso. What is his nationality?
Oh.
He's like, oh no. Back to the sports question.
Please, back to the sports
question. Honestly, yeah.
Oh, I'm supposed to know this. I had a lot of art classes. I have no idea.
Take a stab.
Give me three and then.
Okay.
Give me three and then. I'll tell you which one.
He wants a little multiple choice.
Can I get a little multiple choice?
We're with that.
I got to go three for five.
That's fair.
We'll give you that.
Let me go three.
I just don't know what order to say it in because I don't want to.
It doesn't matter order because
okay, right.
I don't know.
Italian, French, or Spanish? It's real quiet.
French.
Crickets.
He's Spanish.
Oh.
I thought it was French when I looked it up.
Yeah.
Sam told me last time, he's like, LP's into art. I'm like, all right, art trivia.
That's a good question.
Thank you.
But honestly, getting the Leonard Fournette one was...
That
impressed me.
If you would have gotten the Super Bowl one, I would have...
He almost... You were one of...
I was close.
The fact that you knew, you were like, wait, hold up. That hasn't happened a lot.
Yeah,
like,
I know it hasn't happened.
Yeah,
he knows his stuff.
Yeah,
he knows his stuff.
So, not bad.
I was one or two.
Not bad.
I was either going to say zero or two. I don't know why I didn't want to say one, but so.
Not too bad on trivia for Lawrence Pittman.
so now we got it.
Right. Yeah, let's.
We have to mention one thing.
Oh, what is it? What we got?
The shoes.
Oh.
Well, actually, can we bring out Josh real quick?
Yeah, Josh, come on out here.
Our director of photo.
Josh has got the Jordan 1 PSG Lowe's.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Wow. That's nice. Wow. I'm rocking with those.
I thought my shoes were cool.
Those are cool. Those are clean. You. I like those.
Thank I honestly you. Thought mine were pretty sweet, but that's a lie, actually.
Yeah, you know, it's okay.
No, you don't. These are bad. I got these at all.
Are you a big Yeezy guy?
Yeah, I like them.
Is that your favorite one, or you like the?
I think these are like my favorite ones.
Favorite ones?
Wave runners. They're cool. They're comfortable. You know.
They look comfortable. I wish I had the money to buy wave runners, but I don't. Settle for the Vans. Cool. I like
Vans. I got a pair of Vans too. I got a pair of black and white ones. I was close to wearing them.
You were thinking. Were you thinking a little bit about what you were gonna bring out?
I mean,
wear?
Did you think about it? Your wardrobe.
I mean, I like to dress.
You know. We're in episode two.
I like to dress a little bit, yeah. You know, especially like, you know, before games and stuff like that.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's kind of like a.
Of course.
So it's like, I might as well throw something on, you know?
Right.
So
I like it.
All right. Well,
awesome.
This has been a blast.
We
appreciate your time,
awesome.
Man.
Appreciate you having me. Appreciate
Thanks
you having
again,
me here.
Man. Awesome.
All right, LP.
Thank
Sam,
you.
Well, good luck in the future.
Sam, yeah, LP. You. Oh, wait. Before you go. What is your plug?
The plug. The
so plug anything, whether it's, you know, your social media, anything going on in your personal life.
Y'all can just keep in touch with me on Twitter, at LP_22X, and then on IG at LPit_. Keep in touch.
Awesome. Yep. Sam, LP, Donnie, we're out.
Deuces.
Yep.